I'm Jack Arute, along with Nebraska's head coach, Frank Solich. Frank, this is the beginning of your march to a potential national championship.
Well, we've got a very good football team, but we'll have to play great football to get it done here today. Should be a great college football game. We're really looking forward to it.
Some miscommunication at the toss. What happened?
Well, one of our captains got confused out there with the official, and they ended up getting both the ball and the win.
Good luck today.
Thank you.
Brent.
Oh, Jack, it brings to mind one of the great incidents in the old American Football League. Overtime. Hank Stram, I believe it was Abner Haynes, will kick to the wind. Oh, mercy. So Major Applewhite will get the ball on the first series against Nebraska with the breeze at his back, Gary.
Brent, they say the breeze, the wind is tough in Texas, but it's not that tough. It's left to right, and that's the direction Texas is going.
Montrell Flowers and Jeremy Jones back deep to return this kick by the punter, Dan Haydenfelt, who also handles the kicking off duties for the Cornhuskers. Short to the 10. Jones, because of the wind, an alley. The first advantage because of the wind is the return to the 36-yard line. Major Applewhite comes out, and we asked him the key to beating Nebraska today.
I think the key for the offense is going to be real patient the whole afternoon, not just the first quarter, second quarter, but the whole afternoon. This game will probably be an ugly game.
Probably an ugly game, but they'll take an ugly win, won't they?
First down. Ugly is in the eyes of the beholder, and Texas wants it ugly today.
Major spots the bump and run, and now the corner, Craver, backs off for Nebraska. They show pressure from the blind side, gets time, deflected, jump ball, caught. Nunez off the deflection, and that's a gain of about 7 yards off the pass. Our Chili's starting lineup here today. Roger Raisler, he's the rock of the offensive line for the Horns. 25th straight start. Kwame Cavill, Cadillac is nicknamed, the go-to wide man, especially on third down. Hodges Mitchell, he has picked it up as the running back. We expect to see a lot of him. Second down and four officially across the way. Here is Hodges' first carry into the middle of the black shirts, short of the first down. Defensively, Nebraska lines up this way. Lauren Kaiser will be busy. Steve Warren has been outstanding, but Kaiser will be challenged there at the defensive tackle spot. Carlos Polk and Tony Ortiz expected to blitz. One of the better secondaries in all of college football, led by number 22, Ralph Brown. Stepped in, started as a freshman, still there. Third down and one for Texas. Mitchell, first down.
Brand, let's take a look at the Dell Game Solutions for Texas. We said it in the open, never stop running. Even if they don't run the ball well, they can't do it. Patience versus a great defense. You know, a punt isn't a bad thing. And Nebraska, you've already seen it once, Brent. Get in the face of a smaller Major Applewhite. Tip some passes. He's not going to hold the ball a long time to throw it, so they might be able to tip some.
The corners show bump and run. They've got single coverage out wide. Applewhite goes on the slant. An 8-yard incompletion waved off.
Let's take a look at Major Applewhite, what he does well and why he's a good college quarterback. First of all, intense preparation. He's like Peyton Manning, the way he gets ready to play a game, and he's extremely accurate, except for that last pass. And his weaknesses, you know, he kind of fights his own stereotype, Brent. You know, he's smaller, he's got a 6'5" blonde guy behind him, and people, every time he doesn't do well, kind of questions if he's the right guy.
Second down and 10. His favorite receiver is lined in the slot, away from the corner. They run the formation. Hodges Mitchell pounds it, breaks free. 30-yard line, down at the 19-yard line. Clint Finley, the free safety, saves a touchdown, but it's a 33-yard gain.
You really see the offensive game plan developing early for Texas. They want to spread out this Nebraska team, and then when they got their young, quick running back behind them, Hodges Mitchell, then use his speed to run the short draws up the gut. Nebraska will see that throughout the whole game.
Applewhite leads the Horns out in the straight eye. Ricky Brown, the fullback. He'll lead the way with the block. Mitchell patiently on a cutback, and Nebraska sealed it off on the inside, and not much doing that time.
You know, Brent, Nebraska's only given up 80 yards rushing a game, but I'm not quite sure they've, well, I know, they haven't faced anybody like this offense that Mack Brown. Mack Brown has run offenses and been successful with offenses wherever he's gone. He had 6 1,000-yard rushers when he was at North Carolina, and he's producing a running attack here for Texas.
Second down and 9. Applewhite, pocket hold, slant, incomplete. Great coverage by Keo Craver out of Harlington, Texas. This is a tough Nebraska D. Even though Hodges Mitchell ran roughshod, you can see, Gary, how well they rank in the conference right now.
Well, some of that is because of who they played, and we'll develop that a little bit later, but you know this Nebraska defense that Charlie McBride has designed. Tom Osborne has called it the best defense he's seen at Nebraska. The coaches say we'll evaluate that at the end of the season.
Third down and 9. Three wideouts and the shotgun for Applewhite. Now drops it off to Flowers. Nothing doing. Fumble. Applewhite's got it on the bounce. And he is down at the 27-yard line. There is an indication of why the Cornhuskers have sparkled and impressed Osborne defensively this year.
Brent, I believe that was Kwame Cavill that caught that slip screen right there. But I think if you're Texas, you're happy that you got a chance. Chris Stockton has a chance to put the lead to Texas's way. Very safe pass.
It'll be a 44-yard attempt. Off the upright, no good. Score one, big one for the Nebraska defense.
And Brent, without the fumble back that Major would have recovered, they would have made that field goal and hooked into the post.
Timeout in Austin.
One more look at the fumble by Kwame Cavill. It is a middle screen, Brent. Now watch as he catches it cleanly. And then from the backside, I think it's Eric Johnson that gets his hand on the ball. And those 7 yards cost him 3 points.
And Eric Johnson returning to the lineup. Injured knee, missed 3 games for the Cornhuskers. Now it's Eric Crouch and the Nebraska option attack. Running right straight ahead. A power look with Dan Alexander on first down, and he breaks it for 10 yards. Here's Dominic Raiola, the first player recruited out of Hawaii by Nebraska, anchors the offensive line. Bobby Newcomb, the former starting quarterback, now at wide receiver, and Eric Crouch from Omaha Millard North High School, the man under center with a first and 10. Comes down the line with the option, keeps it, crease, fumble! Texas jumps on it. The first turnover.
Well, remember the big fumble a year ago in this game. Eric Crouch in the third quarter could have put it away. I think it was Aaron Humphrey that caused it. Option coming this way. Ducks up inside. Let's see who gets the hit. From the backside, the ball pops loose. I'm not sure. I think it was Casey Hampton that made the hit. And all of a sudden, Eric Crouch, another turnover, and he remembers the one from last year.
Now a chance from the Nebraska 42-yard line. Cavill in motion back toward the line. Play fake. Major comes up firing. Got it complete to the 29-yard line. Kwame Cavill. First down. John Saunders, we are stunned about the Michigan score here in Austin, my friend.
Brent, you're stunned. Boy, are they stunned in Ann Arbor here in the Burger King update. Hadn't lost to the Illini at home since 1993. Rocky Harvey here, 51 yards from Kurt Kittner, 28-27. They gave up 28 unanswered points, and the Illini win it, Brent.
So a shocker in the Big Ten. Here's Hodges Mitchell. And the black shirts climb all over him. In the middle of that defense, Aaron Wills, number 81, and number 13, the middle linebacker, Carlos Pope.
When you say something has to give, this is the game. I mean, you got the best defense so far in the Big 12 and the best offense so far. I believe unless Nebraska can put pressure on Major Applewhite, they're going to be in trouble. He'll find enough ways to throw the ball to keep this Nebraska defense off balance.
Split backs on second and 11. Brown, the fullback, bounces off the first hit for 3 yards. Finley cleans it up.
You know, Brent, Nebraska's first drive, it's always a bad sign when you can't get the lineups in and the other team has the ball. That's a bad drive.
That's right.
We don't even know who's playing yet, and Texas has got the ball again.
Third down and 8.
And the wind. Remember that. Wind is going this direction in this football game. Texas got the ball and the wind because of mistake.
Applewhite looks left, throws, deflected. With that three-quarter throwing motion, that sometimes is what goes wrong for the major. He'll get it down too low and it'll be deflected.
You're right. The major is, they list him as 6'1". But he's probably 5'11". He does not throw it from over his helmet. It's kind of three-quarter, as you say. And Joe Walker, the blitzing nickelback, basically, who's 5'10", knocked it down. That's another guy in his face. That's got to be the game plan for Nebraska.
Now a 43-yard attempt for Chris Stockton, his second field goal attempt here of this young game. Starts this one further right and just draws it in beautifully. One of two, and as a result, Texas scores first. So they take advantage of the first turnover in the game, a fumble by Eric Crouch, who had a seam. And then Aaron Humphrey pounces on the loose ball. Texas leads it. Timeout. Eric Crouch and Nebraska trailing, but they have to be happy that in two opportunities, Texas has only 3 points to show for it. So Crouch and the offense will be coming back up after this kickoff. It's a gorgeous Saturday afternoon. Record crowd here in Austin. Burnt orange across the way and a lot of Nebraska red down to my left in that end zone. Walker and Stella back deep. And a beautiful kick with that wind.
Big miscue so far in this game has been the wind.
So Eric Crouch, we ask him what has to happen for the option to be successful.
You got to know exactly what play to get into. You need to go. You need to be able to know what side is the best side for that play. And everybody else on the field has to also execute it 100%.
And I think you know the response from Texas. It is going to be pound the quarterback and pound him again time after time. And a throw on first down out wide, but nothing doing. Ahmad Brooks, the corner, jumps all over that play, and our Chili's Texas defensive line, Cedric Woodard, he will spend some time at tackle as well as defensive end. The linebackers are going to be extremely busy here today. DeAndre Lewis in the middle, Babineau and Rawls, and then that defensive backfield, Lee Jackson, the strong safety. Expect him to cheat up close to that line of scrimmage when they expect to see the option coming. DeAndre looks down across the line, sees what kind of an offensive set. And on second and 10, Crouch under pressure. Down he goes, no time. The Longhorns jumped all over the Cornhuskers offensive line that time.
Well, I think Texas has these Dell game solutions down pretty well. You said it, Nebraska first when they have the ball, they have to keep their offense wide open. Brent, in the last three games on first down, they're averaging 50% more passes than they did on first down in the first three games. Texas, be physical with Eric Crouch, hit him like you said, hit him and hit him, and then it's anybody but Eric Crouch. The I-back can beat him, the wide receivers can beat him, but don't let the quarterback beat him.
On third and 8, Crouch over Newcomb's head and out of bounds. Nebraska is forced to punt. DeAndre Lewis, what do you have to do to beat Nebraska here today? Here's what he said.
Just keep hitting them every play, you know. And you just got to keep hitting them. Don't ever give up, you know. Don't ever stop. Just keep hitting them.
And we could see the game plan unfolding right
there. That was
right
the theme, wasn't it? You notice I didn't get too close to any of those interviews.
Hayden Felt standing back inside the 10-yard line with Garcia back on the Longhorns 39, set to return this punt.
Boy, that wind
just held
that ball.
The wind just holds it up. Fair catch at the 44-yard line. Only 34 yards. The wind, the big factor in this game, and so too the Longhorn defense led by Lewis. Timeout. This is only the second time Nebraska has trailed this year. Southern Miss struck first. In an earlier game, the Cornhuskers rallied to win that one.
Brent, perfect mix so far for Texas. Six runs, six passes.
Applewhite eyes the defense, sees a single safety back there. Back straight back. To the right, complete to midfield, a gain of 5 yards. An ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by the Grand Am with solid form design, its excitement well built from Pontiac. Chili's, a proud sponsor of ABC College Football, Ameritrade, believe in yourself, and Sears and the Sears National Champion Football Trophy. You look down on Royal Memorial Stadium on a beautiful Saturday afternoon in Austin, Texas. It's the Longhorns and the Cornhuskers. Second down and 5 for the Major. Wanted to set the screen and it was incomplete. Nebraska simply blew the play up. They were all over it, and Julius Jackson had coverage at midfield, and Applewhite 4 of 8 for 17 yards here.
Brent, Hodges Mitchell gives Texas something, quickness and speed, but Nebraska can take advantage of his size. That time Hodges had to come up and try to take on a blitzing linebacker. And you know, Kansas State exploited the size of Hodges Mitchell when they put a lot of pressure on Major Applewhite a couple weeks ago.
McBride uses a fifth defensive back, a nickel. Jeremy Jones, the extra Longhorn wide receiver on 3rd and 5. They show safety blitz. They may back out of it, and they do. Applewhite gets time through high. Nunez couldn't get the handle. Threw it just a little bit too high, or they might have had a first down on that side. I say might have, because the defensive back, in that instance, the linebacker, Eric Johnson, number 27, was closing in. There's the fastest fellow, by the way. You caught a glimpse of him. Eric Johnson is the fastest player on the Nebraska team. Now, Bobby Newcomb doesn't want to hear me say that, because he says he'll outrun him for 40 yards.
Remember the problems Texas has had in punt formation.
Using Stockton to punt it, and it's a beauty. Beautiful punt. Fielded at the 6-yard line by Craver, and down right away. Now that is good special teams play. 44 yards on a high punt with hang time and only a 1-yard return. Well, Monday night on ABC, the bus is coming to a neighborhood near you. Jerome Bettis and the Pittsburgh Steelers will be taking on the struggling Atlanta Falcons. That's live at 9 Eastern, and at halftime, the Bowl Championship Series standings for college football. Now, Cornhusker fans, if you pull this one out, you don't want to miss that Monday night halftime.
Isn't Pittsburgh the winniest team in the 90s, Brent?
On Monday night football.
Yes, that's right. You
that's
got
it. Danny Alexander, and they use the fullback, Willie Miller. He's recovering from an ankle problem, so they use him on the carry.
You know, we've kind of set this matchup that it's Texas's offense against Nebraska's defense. But this Texas defense is pretty good right here. I mean, they're only giving up 93 yards a game, and everyone has had a tough time running the ball against this big front four. I think those two defensive tackles, Rodgers and Hampton, as good as they got in college football.
Second down and 9. The toss, Alexander found a crease and powered his way. Now, you know, he's not the prototype I-back at Lincoln, but I think you could see the power that Dan Alexander possesses. He won't turn a 9-yard gain into a 40-yard touchdown like well, Amon Green or Calvin Jones, but that was a powerful run for a Nebraska first down.
Well, you know, Frank Solich calls the plays for Nebraska, and he's getting a pretty good read on what Texas is giving him. They're giving him everything but the quarterback. So you see, Nebraska's gone to their power game. Run the pitch. The quarterback will be there, at least in Frank's mind, a little later in the game. 50% of their plays from two tight ends and a tailback is the option.
Using Miller again. Burnt orange all over him at the 19-yard line. With Gary Danielson and Jack Arute, I'm Brent Musburger. Welcome to Austin, Texas. The Longhorns, who have upset Nebraska twice in a row, including Big 12 championship and an incredible win in Lincoln, trying to make it three straight here, and they strike first. They had two field goal opportunities in the early going, converted the second one. Nebraska, because of confusion on the coin flip, kicked into the wind, so they gave Texas the ball and the wind at their back, and the wind has been a slight factor here. Second down and eight, clock's going nowhere.
See, they don't care. They do not care that it's an option play. Brent, the play previous, Eric Crouch handed the ball off to the fullback, and he got tackled. They're going to tackle Eric Crouch. They're going to run it like he's the tailback. He's going to have to pitch the ball on the option until they take the pressure off the quarterback.
Carl Reich designed the defensive game plan going against Solich and the Huskers here today, and he's one of the fine veteran defensive coordinators. A timeout called by Nebraska. Now, we talked about Reese, and Gary, you had a chance to put him to the blackboard.
Yep.
And get him to design exactly how he would defend Crouch in the option. Here's what he had to say.
Crouch is actually reading the end man on the line of scrimmage, who we want to slow play to the pitch and change up with our tackle and bring him on Crouch, get there ahead of time, and as we're doing that, we want to bring the safety and the wheel linebacker in those gaps.
That's the game plan, and you know, a big part of that game plan is those two big defensive tackles for Texas. Casey Hampton and Sean Rogers are almost unblockable one-on-one, so they have to commit less players to the fullback, allowing other guys to tackle the quarterback. Very interesting game plan for Texas.
And you know, Gary, Crouch has carried it three times for 6 yards, and he's had the one big turnover, which resulted in a field goal. So far, Carl Reese, who joined Mac Brown's staff, leaving LSU to come over here, and wasn't that wise on Reese's part, or maybe he's one of the reasons why, because the gossip down south is that Jerry DiNardo will be replaced as the LSU head coach next year. LSU very disappointing last season, and they're still struggling this year. So the word is that DiNardo has told his assistant coaches to think about selling their homes when this season is over. So the end is near in Baton Rouge. Third down now and 9.
There's Bobby Newcomb right there. Has not touched the ball yet in this game.
Overthrew him, and their only opportunity to try and get it to him. Crouch throws again. Davison's got it. His second reception. First down. Matt Davison, the junior from Tecumseh, Nebraska.
Tremendous throw by Eric Crouch. I mean, he had pressure in his face. This is an option quarterback. Everybody wants to stop him running the ball, but watch this. Gets the ball. He's got pressure right in his face. He lets this ball go, just lobs it out to the outside. Perfect throw, and that's something Texas will have to live with. If he's that good, more power to him.
Ball spotted at the 33-yard line. First down for Nebraska, trailing it by a field goal. Crouch back in the gun, and that inside handoff to the eye back from that spot for a couple of yards. Well, there's a bright orange monster over the stadium today, and the Monster.com blimp is bringing us these magnificent views from above. Monster.com is the leading global careers website, offering opportunities from intern to CEO.
Well, I had my resume on there for a while. Did you? We all did, didn't we?
What do we have to trade for you, my friend? Huh? We also give a draft choice to get you.
I'm here.
Welcome aboard. Here's the I-back, Danny Alexander, the 42-yard line.
Let's take a look at Eric Crouch and why he's such a dynamic quarterback. He has explosive speed and a powerful arm. A lot of schools recruited him as a passer, and he is extremely confident. He knows he's the man to lead Nebraska to the national championship. His weaknesses, he can't get hurt. He's the only guy that can lead this team to the championship, and he gets hit almost every play.
Tyrone Euler, as they stack up that I formation, they run Alexander, and he battles his way for a first down. Strong fella.
Great second effort to get that one. No, Brent, Nebraska has survived this first quarter. Major Applewhite was not on target with his passes early in the game. Remember last week against Oklahoma, he had a lot good game, 300 yards plus, but he was 7 for 24 in the first half. He continues to miss some passes, and that gave Nebraska time to regroup. 2 minutes left in the first quarter, they're going to survive.
Another power-looking formation is Aaron Galladay. Freshman from York, Nebraska, checks in as one of the tight ends. Now he signals which direction he wants to go. It's a numbers game. They'll use Alexander picking his way, and Texas was not fooled by the formation. Lee Jackson makes the stop, and we go down to our partner, Jackaroo. Jack?
Well, Brent, if you take a look at college football polls, you normally see Nebraska on it. But if you go back to October in 1981, go all the way down, not first, not ninth, not 15th, not 20th. Nebraska was nowhere there. Texas was. It was 300 consecutive weeks since then that Nebraska's been ranked in the top 25. Oh, yeah, they had another streak get dropped last year. That was streak in the top 10 when they lost to Texas.
That was on an October Saturday in Lincoln. And again, Crouch with the clock coming down on him.
Play a game already. Had a timeout and a delay of game. So
5-yard penalty.
You know, Brent, one of the things that Mack Brown wanted from his crowd at Texas was more of a frenzied atmosphere. You know, this was almost Silicon Valley South here if we come to Austin, Texas. He said, I want to feel it like the Southeastern Conference, like the old Big 8 days, like Oklahoma. Today, he's got it. He has that type of crowd here.
Wilson Thomas in as one of the wideouts. Option, Crouch gonna keep it and try to get the corner. Spins off the second hit. But well short of the first down, and a program reminder that it's the last chance to qualify now for the Tour Championship. Tiger Woods headlining the field. He's been doing well. The PGA Tour players swing for the green at the National Car Rental Golf Classic tomorrow live at 4 Eastern on ABC. Third down and 8 for Nebraska. Here comes the blitz. Picked up. Crouch goes downfield. Incomplete. Intercepted. But there's a penalty flag.
It's going to be pass interference.
He pushed off and then made the catch. Did Greg Brown, the free safety.
Greg Brown has been playing great football for Texas. Made a mental mistake right there. That ball was going to come to him anyway. The ball kind of fluttered up in the air. Now, I don't know if it was tipped. If it was tipped, it's going to count as an interception. I think what happened is the quarterback got hit and the ball just fluttered.
Well, there's the penalty signal against the Longhorns going to come downfield.
It's not a bad mistake by Greg Brown. He thought the ball was tipped. You're going to see Crouch as he lets it go. This is just a knuckleball. He didn't get hit. And Greg Brown kind of panics. He could have probably, this ball was overthrown anyway, and you really couldn't see the push on the play from the backside. Brent, remember a week ago when Eddie Drummond had his hand held on that long pass and he didn't turn around and talk to the referee? Applegate turned right around and pointed to the referee. That might have helped on the call.
That is, and it was up at Penn State last week. Drummond didn't get that call, but Penn State still came back. This is Miller, and he is just stuffed in the hole. Lee Jackson comes in. Sean Rogers joins him in making the stop, the big defensive lineman. Purdue runs for its first touchdown, and that figures to be a wild one up at West Lafayette, Gary's old school.
One of the things that the BCS has done is everybody's interested in what everybody else is doing now, especially Penn State.
Second down and 10. Motion is started, and it's Newcomb. They overload to the right side. It'll be Newcomb. They try to get Newcomb some running room. Gets the corner, and he is out of bounds inside the 35-yard line. Well, let's find out how Purdue scored. Gary, let's send everybody now to John Saunders in New York. John?
Grant, you know Purdue is scoring. That Drew Brees is having a hand at it some way. Here he tosses it out to Vinny Sutherland, who does a nice job running the ball deep down to the 9. Two plays later, it was Cedric Brown who would take it in. Purdue trying to knock Penn State from the ranks of the undefeated 7-0. Grant.
All right, John, that figures to be a dandy. Joe Pa told us before we left that he'd try to control the ball and keep it out of Brees' hands if he could. 3rd and 5. Here comes Alexander. He's short of the first down. Great defense that time by Sean Rogers, the junior defensive tackle. Switch the wind, ladies and gentlemen. It goes the other way in the second quarter. Timeout. Texas leads it. Start the second quarter, big fourth down. No field goal team on the field for Nebraska, Gary.
Yeah, but Brent, remember, there's the down marker. There's the other one. It's less than 5 yards. It could use the hard count and try to steal 5 yards.
Well, let's see what Crouch does. They load the eye. Now option to the short side of the field. Crouch not going to get it. Ridden out of bounds. Texas football.
Boy, that was a big gamble, I think. Don't you, Brent? That was a tough call. This is a tough defensive rush team for Texas. And they're geared in there, Crouch. He's going to have to pitch the ball. They're going to have to run some counters. I don't believe they're going to let him do this very simply. Inside the two big guys. There you see it. Pushing, getting that depth into the backfield to make that option tough. And that's why it was cleaned up.
I suppose in support of the decision is the fact that this is such a good defense. But
yep,
against
right.
It is the fact that you might be able to bury Texas down inside the 10-yard line.
It's 6 of 1, half dozen the other. But, you know, now Texas has to go against the wind. And maybe Nebraska doesn't believe they can run the ball on them against the wind.
Well, Mitchell trying, and he cuts his way to the 38-yard line. And Clint Finley, both these safeties, Mike Brown and Finley, along with Craver and Ralph Brown on the corners. Outstanding defensive backfield.
You can see how tough Nebraska is. They've given up on defense only 58 points this year. 55 of them have come in the second half. Look at what they're doing against the rush.
Ralph Brown, who stepped in as a freshman, one-on-one toward the bottom of your screen for Coach McBride. And the black shirts, they get ready. Single safety. Here comes Mitchell, cuts back. And he has stopped short of the first down at the 41-yard line. They're going to need 3 yards. Eric Johnson, returning from the injury, the senior out of Phoenix, Arizona, makes the stop.
Texas loves these third and shorts when they can do anything with the ball. Kwame Canville can go out for 5 yards. They can run the ball. They love this matchup. Brent, one more thing. Hodges Mitchell's moved back to 8 yards. That has helped him in his running game the last 3 games.
Able to see the hole a little bit better as he comes up to the line.
It was a pass.
On 3rd down, Applewhite wants to set it. Incomplete. Flowers had a 1st down if he could have held on, but he could not. And it's punting time. So there we go back to Solich's decision on 4th down. 3 and out. So he did give up some yardage in a field position game, but they did not give up any score.
You know, Brent, I've watched a couple of game films, and I knew when Hodges Mitchell shifted up, it was going to be a pass play. Charlie McBride has watched every game film. He knew that was going to be. That was an audible my major, and he gave away the play by doing it.
Now Ryan Long in to punt this time. Joe Walker back deep, but remember how Nebraska does it. They offset one if they try to punt away from him, and it is Newcomb. Down the middle, and Walker lets it roll.
Perfect.
Dead. Beautiful punt. It'll be Nebraska football on their own 12-yard line, a 45-yard punt. Timeout. Austin, Texas, as we come down look at the tower here at the University of Texas.
Of course, with a victory, that'll be orange, burnt orange tonight.
Let's see if Nebraska elects now to go with the option on first down. Crouch keeps it, turns upfield, slips free, and Gary Danielson had a chance in his playbook to talk about what Crouch wants on the option.
One yard can mean so much. When Eric Crouch comes down on the option, he doesn't want any penetration so he can get here quick. But what happens when Texas gives him a little penetration? Even if they don't tackle him, it slows him down and allows those linebackers to make a play.
And on that last play, there was not the penetration for the defensive tackles, and it allowed Crouch to gain 8 yards. Now Coral Buckholder checks into the game, and he pounds away. But let's show you the difference. Let's go back, Gary, to that fourth down play and
watch the defensive tackles. Inside, Casey Hampton pushes Crouch. Look, he's still going backward right there. He wanted to be into the line of scrimmage, and that allowed that defense time to get Eric Crouch. Penetration, it may be just 1 yard, but those two defensive tackles, they're both over 300 pounds, are so important in this game.
They stack the eye again. Applegate goes in motion, play fake,
Wide open.
Gonna throw. Got it, Wistrom, 45-yard line, 30, down to the 27-yard line. Tracy Wistrom, the younger brother of Grant, comes up with another big play, but there is a penalty flag.
It's going to be rough on the passer on Eric Crouch. You remember the game plan, hit him in the mouth? That's what they did. They hit him in the mouth. A play-action pass, two tight ends, three I-backs, and Nebraska's been doing this, what, for 25 years, Brent? Same plays. Turner Gill could come back here and run this offense. See, I got a little nervous there. I've never seen a guy that wide open in my life.
Personal foul. Illegal use of the helmet on the defense. First down. Attack it on it at the end of the run.
Play action pass. Ball is let go, and then there you see it very, very clearly. Sean Rogers. Brent, if he was in the NFL, he'd be fined for that hit. Using the top of his helmet to hit the quarterback. Tracy Wistrom is the recipient of the play. And this guy doesn't catch a pass unless it's 30 yards.
And with the penalty, the ball inside the 15-yard line. They keep the eyes stacked. Start the extra back, Euler in motion. On Buckhalter, just short of the 10-yard line, Jackaroot.
Well, Brent, as we watched Wistrom take in that pass, he may be 30 pounds lighter than any other tight end on the Nebraska depth chart. But when you ask Coach Ron Brown, his receivers coach, what makes Wistrom so good? He looks back to, remember the North Carolina State basketball team? And there was a guy named Spud Webb, little. Well, he says that's the same case with Wistrom. Both of them share one quality. They're tenacious, and they never give up.
It's just like his brother, Grant, who's not given up with the unbeaten St. Louis Rams these days. Play fake in trouble. Crouch, fumble, Texas recovers at the 20-yard line. The second Nebraska turnover of this game.
A fierce competitor, but sometimes discretion would be the better part of its decision here. A lot of pressure on this bootleg play coming out this way, but the pressure to make the play comes inside from those defensive tackles again. Stopped right there, and there's the big fella, Casey Hampton. It causes the fumble, spins him loose. The second guy comes up, I think it was Cedric Woodard that caused the fumble, really.
And Everick
Rawls.
There's
two type clips.
Everick Rawls recovers the fumble. And it is first down. Here's the end around. And dancing over there on that side is Jeremy Jones, and the Husker defense ready. the Rover man, Mike Brown. So our Aflac trivia question today, when was the last time now Nebraska lost three consecutive games to a conference opponent? I'm going to tell you something. I think everybody in Lincoln, no, the whole state of Nebraska has got
one.
The answer to
this
that.
This is a gimme.
Is this your
gimme.
Question?
This is a gimme.
This is way too easy.
Well, I'm not from around here.
Come on.
You know, what can I say?
LeVar Arrington on the scoreboard for the Nittany Lions. Big number 11. Their All-American linebacker ties the game. Second down, Hodges Mitchell. And you have got to be impressed by the defense as Warren, number 96, storms across from McBride's D.
When you watch both of these teams play defense, you know why they're good football teams. I mean, we saw Penn State last week. We just heard about LeVar Arrington. There's 5, 6, 10 defensive teams in the country, and Nebraska and Texas are two of the top 10 in the country. Nebraska obviously is up there in the top 5.
Third and 21.
Major Applewhite is 1 for 5, his last 5 attempts thrown. This will be very conservative or a draw.
And they did run the draw play with Hodges Mitchell trying to get some of it back before they punt, just to give the punter a little bit more room out to the 14-yard line.
Remember the goal for Texas, win ugly. We don't have to put on a show here. We punt the ball, trust our defense.
And Newcomb set to return this punt. So unable to handle the ball with a pass so far, they put him back as a single return man. Opened the season as Nebraska's starting quarterback, gave way to Eric Crouch. Now a wing back and a backup quarterback, low punt. Gonna take a hop and gonna be well covered. Inside the 35-yard line, and if there's any improvement we see with this Texas team so far, it has been their punting team, even though we do have a penalty flag thrown back by the 10-yard line. So they'll bring this one back.
When Nebraska only puts one returner back there, Texas is almost quick kicking it. They just want a low kick and get it out there. They know that Nebraska's going for the blocked punt. And Texas's motor is really running when they only put one guy back there.
Well, Mac Brown and Texas burn, and so far this season, to give you an idea of what Gary's talking about, the Cornhuskers have come storming on their special teams. Look at this, loose in the end zone for a touchdown against Iowa State. Just an example of how effective they are, and Texas must be very concerned because, remember, three punts were blocked in their opening game by North Carolina State, and the last one resulted in the Wolfpack beating the Longhorns here in Austin. The line of scrimmage now is back on the 7-yard line. The punter standing in his own end zone this time, Ryan Long.
Watch Randy Stella right here. He's the punt blocking expert right on the end of the line.
He just gets out as well as he can. Picked up by Joe Walker. Walker looking alley. Great field position or better. Inside the 20-yard line. Nebraska with another golden opportunity. But can they cash in? They have not so far against Carl Reese's Texas defense.
5-yard penalty or 10-yard penalty for holding cost Texas, what, 25 yards on that exchange right there? 14 penalties last week in a win over Oklahoma. Those penalties come back and kill you.
Evo hoping the defense can hold again here. Buckhalter still in as the eye back. First down and 10. The pitch to Buckhalter. Nothing doing. Loses a yard on the sharp tackle by Sean Rogers. He may have been penalized, but he has been a force in that defensive line for the Horns. When you think about their defensive line, Rogers along with Cedric Woodard, Casey Hampton and Aaron Humphrey. This is one of the better quartets in college football.
Absolutely. Brad, when you look at a defense and the 7th leading tackler is the first time you talk about a linebacker. They have a lot of other guys. Those front four make a lot of tackles.
Second down and 12. Option short side. Buckhalter on a great pitch. Buckhalter to the six. It's a first down, Nebraska. And that a fine pitch by Eric Crouch, who got to the corner and tossed it late.
Brent, here's what number seven, Eric Crouch, is looking at. Two deep safeties. He's going to check to the option away from those two guys. It's a numbers game. Remember what Eric Crouch said. I'm going to look up there, make good decisions. When he has two safeties, Nebraska will run the ball.
Nebraska looking to score for the first time. Miller the fullback, Buckhalter behind him. Two tight ends and Davis in the wideout. Option, Crouch keeps it, nothing doing. Second and a goal.
Option is practically 50% of Nebraska's offense after the first three games because their best ball carrier is their quarterback. Nobody cares for Texas about the pitch man. Eric Crouch has to pitch the ball.
Wilson Thomas brings the play in for the Huskers, and he is split out to the right. Applegate in the slot. There's the pitch again. Buckhalter cut off at the 5-yard line, and it is third and goal. Irvis Hill, starting corner, along with Aaron Humphrey, flows off the alley.
Mack Brown
wanting holding.
Yeah, he's trying to get one. He's like a basketball coach now, trying to get in the official's head. He knows the next one is coming his way, and he has to keep reminding the officials that he's over there.
Applegate brings the play from Frank Solich. Third down, this for the lead. Play fake, Crouch, cut off, now going to throw it, incomplete. Fourth and goal, Texas holds again.
Nice coverage from number 24, Greg Brown, on Tracy Wistrom. But you know, the play again was made by that front four. Cedric Woodard this time, the end man. Watch him come up and get in Eric Crouch's face. Doesn't go for the fake. He just gets up there and makes the play. And there's the nice coverage in the end zone by the safety, Greg Brown.
Josh Brown to attempt the tying field goal. Frankie London, his holder. This a 22-yarder. This for the tie. Got it. Deadlocked at three apiece. The story of the day so far in Austin. Defense, defense, and more defense. I'm out. It's a wonderful Saturday afternoon here in Austin, Texas. It's one of the great stops on the college circuit. Sixth Street was rocking last night, ladies and gentlemen, having a good time. Veterans Day parade. Hayden felt to kick it off for Nebraska.
And what's better than football down in Texas, where it all began? Steve Worcester, Earl Campbell, 3-3, 6 minutes to go. This is the type of defensive football that everybody grew up loving.
Coming out on the 20-yard line. An ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Ford Outfitters, no boundaries. Aflac, without it, no insurance is complete. Budweiser, delivered fresh daily from our local brewery near you. And Applebee's, you belong at Applebee's. Clydesdale's prancing down 6th Street.
Yeah, it was beautiful. Yeah.
Well, Purdue jumps right back and takes a 14-7 lead on Penn State. A touchdown pass by Drew Brees, who grew up here in Austin, Texas, went to Westlake High School, having another great season down here. I think that's Division 5A. Some fellows were telling me. A lot of good players over there again.
Ryan Nunes, Westlake High School.
First down and 10. Here's Applewhite. Incomplete. Threw high that time. Receiver was covered, and it'll be second down.
Branty threw high because he had another guy in his face again.
So here in Austin, a field goal apiece. Texas with a couple of golden opportunities could not cash in. And then Nebraska couldn't score touchdowns, and they finally settle for the tying field goal here. This will be the largest crowd to watch a sporting event ever in the state of Texas when they announce the official attendance total here in the second half. Second down and 10. Kwame Cavill is number 9. Cuts back. Deflected again.
You know Nebraska. That's red lettered on their game plan. Jump. Three interceptions, three fumbles against Kansas State. You got a smallish quarterback. Get it. This time it's Carlos Polk that gets his hand on it. When he takes that short drop, get your hands up in the air. Force the quarterback to take the deep drop, and then your defensive ends can sack him.
Now Hawaii looks over the defense. Polk is coming right down the middle. Had to fire fast to Nunez. Nunez short of the first down. Third and out under enormous pressure. That was a very fine release by the major that time as Polk was storming after him up the middle.
He had no choice. He held it any longer. The grenade was going to go off.
Here's Ryan Long. And a punt for the Horns. This time Walker and Newcomb.
See, two guys deep. Nebraska won't go for the block. They may get it, but they're not going to go for it. Just holding them up.
Newcomb from the 36 goes nowhere. Most improved unit on this Texas team, their punt team. 37 yards, but only 1 yard on the return. Timeout in Austin. Defense the story. And in the last series, Nebraska had to settle for the field goal because the burnt orange shirts were ready. Incomplete, and it's 3-all. Now Nebraska comes back to work from their own 36-yard line, averaging less than 3 yards a rush in this game. Newcomb, deep set, got it on the handoff, scampers outside, and down he goes. Because Cedric Woodard, 6'3", 295, would not give ground to the faster Newcomb.
Cedric Woodard is such a good player. He's played defensive tackle, defensive end. He's been hitting the quarterback all day. Both of these quarterbacks have been taking some shots. Look at this, 12 hits in the game. This is like a boxing match. You look at these guys, 12 hits so far by Crouch, only 4 by Applewhite. Applewhite's numbers will go up, believe me, because he's going to have to throw the ball.
Buckhalter and Alexander in this set. So they use both high backs. Gonna throw, use them as blockers. Incomplete. Davison on the cut, and he was well covered that time by Ahmad Brooks. All right. The Aflac trivia question. Last time Nebraska lost 3 consecutive games to a conference opponent. You can never be a Nebraska fan if you couldn't answer that one. That is a gimme. Third down and 13. I won't even mention it. I don't want to make
it
feel bad.
I really thought it was the Billy Sims years, though, a little earlier. My old teammate.
Third down and 13. Crouches back, wants a screen. Newcomb slants to the middle. Newcomb is quick and reached out, extending toward the first down. It will depend on the spot as to whether or not he gets it. This one is close. Got it. DeAndre Lewis defending on the play.
You know what's interesting? Bobby Newcomb is the backup quarterback. We talked about all the hits Eric Crouch has taken in warm-ups. Bobby Newcomb did only this. Caught passes and played as a wide receiver. He did not throw one pass. He did not take one handoff. Your backup quarterback is only ready to play wide receiver.
But they do have the pass in for Newcomb on the end around. I will tell you that, my friend. They may not use it today. Here it is. Got his man. Newcomb throws. Got Davison. A 21-yard line.
Were you at Lincoln?
Yes, sir, I was.
That's kind of a funny way to get down to Florida.
Well, but, you know what else is funny about it? I told both Solich and Newcomb I wanted to see the play. Thanks a lot, guys.
We were right on this one. I should say you were right on this one. Bobby Newcomb, the backup quarterback, did not throw one pass in warmups. But you know what? Playing for Nebraska, you don't throw much. So that's no big deal. Bobby Newcomb on the year. He was the starting quarterback this year, and now he's the starting wingback.
He has made that tough transition out of Albuquerque, New Mexico, pounding straight ahead, and there's the defense. Let's go back on Newcomb for a minute, because when I was in Lincoln, I asked him, was it tough for you, Bobby, to go from quarterback back to wingback? Here's what he said.
Yeah, it was a real tough decision to make, you know. Still hurts a little bit, but my mind is a lot clearer right now. Having a lot more fun on the field. Joy's back playing, and we're 6-0.
Let me tell you what my impression of the young man. Very well spoken.
Very intelligent.
Very nice young man and a big hand. He can make it as a wide receiver.
Absolutely. That's his future.
Second down. Crouch takes it away on the belly option. And again it is Texas Aaron Humphrey. Let's find out about Purdue Penn State. Take it away, John Saunders.
Brent, it's been back and forth. Purdue has led twice in the game, leading here when Kevin Thompson comes in and goes 39 yards to Eddie Drummond. He takes it to the end zone to tie the game at 14 apiece. It's been back and forth. And don't forget, for more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the Go Network. Brent.
What a shootout.
You know, everybody talks about Penn State's defense. Their offense is coming on.
Third down now and 20. For Crouch in Nebraska. Crouch throws beautifully to Davison, short of the first down, but back inside the 15, well within field goal range, because it's a 15-yard gain.
Yep.
The coaches stressed in Lincoln that we would be surprised by Crouch's accuracy, and there was a very well-thrown ball that time.
But remember what Eric Crouch has said about his offseason. You know, said, last year, I tried to muscle the ball. This offseason, this spring, I worked on my touch. He's 6-for-9 in the game now, and you know, that is a huge difference. Not even Nebraska can just run the ball anymore in modern college football.
Josh Brown, 32 yards for the lead. There it is. Nebraska leads for the first time. 6-3, and it's timeout. That's at 3:30 Eastern. 2:30 right here in this area, and of course a lot of interest in all of these games around the country. The satellite dish, very helpful this time of year. You can snap around the country, and maybe your cable operators even bringing different games into the area. And of course all that excitement about the bowl championship series. The first set of standings will be out this week. Again, a reminder, just pay attention to the top two teams. That's all they're trying to rank, is to get the Nokia Sugar Bowl. The two teams for
that's
the championship.
That's not fun. You can't yell. You just look at the top two.
First down and 10. I think you can hear somebody say he's coming down there, and then the offensive line broke, and that was the middle linebacker, Carlos Poca, who stepped up into that blitz area.
Dead ball. False start. Offense, 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
The reason Texas has had trouble four straight three and outs is because of this. The first drive, 39 yards rushing. Since then, 7 rushes, 6 yards. The good thing for Texas is they haven't given up on the running game. You know, they got to keep doing it because they're not good enough at offensive tackle to just completely throw the ball every time. Brent, remember Mac Brown telling us the trouble and Greg Davis telling us the trouble they had at tackle in the shotgun because of crowd noise? That got him on that illegal procedure penalty. They even have the offensive linemen holding hands, the guards and the tackles.
And when the guard lets go, the tackle knows that they're changing the play on first and 15. Here it comes. They set the screen. It's Hodges Mitchell. Look at that defensive team speed.
Man.
Are you kidding me? Did you see the black shirts jump on that? From every angle, they told us that this would be one of the fastest overall defenses we would see all year, and I believe it on that play right there.
Well, I almost saw, you know how good this defense is? I almost saw Charlie McBride smile yesterday. Almost. He didn't. That's a good defense when he smiles.
Second down and 20.
Go!
Downfield. Just a little short of Cavill.
The wind held it up. You cannot see that on television. When you throw the ball sideways, the wind kills it.
Well, the great views you're seeing are being brought to us this afternoon by the Monster.com blimp. Monster.com is the leading global careers website. Over 240,000 jobs available. And their Monster campus area has over 50,000 internships available. Monster.com.
There you see Major. Remember last game against Oklahoma, he started 7 for 24. I think he knows he will be able to come back from this. He's been through it.
Third down and 20. The twist, Polk tries to get there, and because of the intense pressure on Applewhite, they just cut down his sight lines that
time,
and he couldn't see a thing.
And he was also throwing to a very short Ryan Nunes, who only goes 5'9". Shorter quarterback, shorter receiver, that makes it tough.
Texas must punt again out of its own end zone. Newcomb and Walker retreat deep. So even a fair catch would give Nebraska real good field position in this situation with about a minute 20 left here in the first half.
Deep backs are only back 30 yards.
Trying to get a bounce on a low kick. Newcomb gonna field it at the 46, gonna cut back and got a great block. Now looking for another one. Got it on the shoulder. Newcomb trying to get the corner turned. Could never get it completely squared up, but that's excellent field position at the 31. That's a 15-yard return. I think Bobby Newcomb has been responsible for the two biggest plays for Nebraska. The pass play for 33 yards and that 15-yard return. John Saunders and Terry Bowden, they'll have their insights. I wonder who Terry's pulling for tonight. Who's he pulling for? His brother down at Clemson or Pop's rolling in with Florida State? If he knows what's good for him, he'll be pulling for Daddy. Daddy's got that new contract,
and
Terry.
The will. Lots the will,
that's right.
Right.
That's right.
Well, Texas defense has to answer their call again.
First down and 10. Buckhalter, the I-back. Storman on the screen. Buckhalter's got it. Left sideline, cut middle. Buckhalter explodes to the 5-yard line. 26 yards, first and goal. Nebraska with two timeouts remaining and 1:03 to work with.
Brent, Eric Crouch is good. I'm telling you why he's good, because he's so two-dimensional. You look at an injury right down there. That's Tyrone Jones, a linebacker who had to come back and help on that play and save a touchdown. But when you have a guy that can run the option this well, look at how everybody's spread out for Texas right here. Three wide receivers, and then you dump it off to the tailback. That's a quarterback that gives you so many options. It's wide open. When this ball is caught, I thought for sure it was a touchdown. Nice job by Tyrone Hill and Aaron Humphrey, number 49, to save this play.
You know, talking about Crouch as a passer, he's 7 of 10 for 121 yards.
See, that's what Frank Solich is doing so well right now. He says, okay, you're going to take him away as a runner? I'll use him as a passer. This is the best passing. I think he's a better passing quarterback than Tommy Frazier. He's not as big as Scott Frost and Tommy Frazier, but he's a better thrower.
With a first and goal from the 6-yard line, Thomas moves over by Applegate to the right side of the formation. Buckhalter is set deep. Numbers to the short side. Here comes the pitch. Buckhalter battles, end zone, got it. Touchdown, Nebraska. Carl Buckhalter. They may not know which way the wind is blowing, but they haven't done much wrong since then, folks.
Well, remember, Corey Buckhalter left the team for 3 days. He was suspended for one game. But right now, everybody on that football team for Nebraska loves this guy. The pitch is there. The pitch is there all game, and Buckhalter takes it, runs over a tackle from Greg Brown, and gets it into the end zone.
Extra point is added. Remember, this is a team that voted not to take D'Angelo Evans. back as a running back. In many ways, that unified this team. They had a players-only meeting they told me about in Lincoln. They said, anybody who doesn't want to stand together now, leave the room right now. Nobody left. Right. Evans was not taken back. This team has not been the same since.
Brent, you know what it was kind of like? It was one of those meetings where you tell everybody, we're going to win with or without you. So get out if you don't want to be a part of it. And the cry almost was, all aboard. Everybody get on the train and let's go try to win a national championship.
Well, we've been talking about the BCS and the BCS online site. You can get post-game video, weekly chats, and of course, the rankings come out every Monday, starting this Monday. So you want to find out where your favorite team stands. Can Virginia Tech make it by playing only cupcakes? We'll find out.
Very interesting today. That loss by Miami of Florida really hurt Virginia Tech.
Critical. The fellows who follow the computers say that if any of the three big three, Florida State, Penn State, and Nebraska, any two of them stay unbeaten, and so does Virginia Tech, they cannot pass any of the three because of strength of schedule if they all run the table. We shall see. Let the arguments begin.
This game's too good to worry about that.
Texas, though, needs to come up with some offense here. Coming out on the 20-yard line. They have been smothered here in the second quarter.
Absolutely. And the main reason is that rush defense. Texas, the last five possessions, what do they got?
Five yards.
Huh?
Look at that.
That reminds me of those days playing against the Chicago Bears. You remember those
days? You still think that was the best defense you ever
played. If you did not play against the Chicago Bears in 1985, you didn't play pro football.
Did you go to sleep, close your eyes, and see Mike Singletary looking at you coming after you?
Yes,
man?
I do, tell you the truth. Texas, very little chance for Texas to drive this ball down far enough to get a field goal. They should be very conservative in the half and try to regroup. Don't make a mistake here.
45 seconds. Applewhite fires complete to Flowers, who's hit at the 25-yard line. Not much doing after the catch as Craver, the corner, pounded into it.
See, this is when, if you're playing on the road, you just take a knee and go in there. But when you got 84,000 Hook'em Horn fans here, you don't take a knee because they'll boo.
Second down and four. Polk trying to get in, trying to get at Applewhite. Deflected pass incomplete.
They must have deflected four passes in this game so far.
Well, I think if they went back and looked hard at that Kansas State tape, then I was down here for this game. The Wildcats got an awful lot of pressure on Major Applewhite. Forced three or six turnovers. I believe it was three interceptions and three fumbles on the day. All those fumbles by Applewhite. They put enormous pressure on a quarterback.
Brent, Texas has to run the ball here because Nebraska's going to take a timeout and force them to punt if they don't get a first down.
Third down and four.
He's going to roll out this way. This is the formation they roll out in.
Delivers it for a first down.
Beautiful.
Big time catch on that far side by Jeremy Jones.
And Texas had to have it because they're going to punt the ball and could force a particular block right there. They needed one first down.
If you weren't with us at the start of the broadcast, Texas had two big scoring opportunities right away in the first quarter. They missed a field goal and then kicked the second one. And with the seconds ticking away, there's the Hodges Mitchell, and he'll go out of bounds and stop the clock with six ticks left.
Tell you, Major Applewhite took a tough one there, and he's come up limping. Chris Sims, the backup quarterback, everybody knows his name, has not played in two games. He's only thrown 11 passes this year. Good job, guys.
And if I was Chris over there on the sideline watching this Nebraska defense, I'd be saying, come on, Major.
Yeah, that's right.
Stay healthy, man.
Come on.
This is not where I'm making
No, but you
my
know he's
debut.
Not. Anybody that's a quarterback wants to be in a football game.
First down and 10.
I tell you, Major's hurting a little.
And they're going to take a timeout, I think, probably as a result of that. Let's check in with Jackaroo. Jack?
Well, Brent, we've heard about it for a long time. The legend of the black shirts with the Nebraska Cornhuskers. These kind of shirts in practice for the potent defense. Well, let's go back to 1964. That's actually where the legend began. It seems that George Kelly, the then defensive coordinator, was instructed by Bob Devaney to go down to the local Lincoln Sporting Goods store and find me some shirts to differentiate between the defense and the offense, because in 64, that's when two platoon football returned to collegiate competition. So what happened with Kelly is all they had were black shirts. Ergo, the legend of the black shirts was actually born by happenstance.
Yeah, it's interesting, Jack, because you talk to the players like Ralph Brown. I said, Ralph, is it automatic when you become a defensive player, they give you a black shirt? He said, no. He said, Coach McBride only gives it to you if you attain, well, starter status or move up that depth chart. He said, I was very lucky to get mine when I checked in because I started as a freshman. And he said, it is a big badge of honor for the youngsters who come and play defense for Nebraska.
6 seconds to go. I think now Texas' only opportunity here is to get a pass interference penalty. I don't think Major can throw it far enough, and if he does, the half's going to end. Three guys down here, they're going to throw the big bend and hope for an interference.
And six guys in white shirts have got different thoughts, but the Major does get it off. Jump ball. Incomplete. The half ends. Nebraska trailing 3-0, scores 13 unanswered points, and they take a 13-3 lead into the locker room here in a big 12 game. There were two key plays in the game. Bobby Newcomb throwing a pass off the end around. That set up a score. Then it was Eric Crouch on the pitch, and it was all desire on the part of Buckhalter. So Nebraska takes a 13-3 lead as the heart of the Cornhusker season is well underway in Austin, Texas.
This is ABC Sports, home of the Bowl Championship Series.
With the Texas State Capitol in the background, it is a stifling Nebraska defense doing a job. 13-3 at the half. We'll show you why Nebraska ranks in the top eight in all four major defensive categories this season. They have not yet allowed a rushing defense by the first team. The black shirts swarming all over Major Applewhite, the running backs, and the wide receivers. No chance as we take a look at the Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter first half stats, and Gary, take a look at the average yards per play there at the bottom of that.
No doubt about that, but this too, Brent, the passing yards, you know, Texas wanted to run the ball, but I don't think they thought they would lose the passing game to Nebraska. This is a critical stop for the Texas defense. They got the wind to their back. They must force Nebraska to punt into the wind early and gain some field position.
Eric Crouch has been averaging about 12 yards a pass, and the Major just over 2 yards a pass, and Walker coming out for the Cornhuskers. Bad gamble down at the 15-yard line. And Eric Crouch. Let's check in now with Jackaroo, Jack.
Well, Brent, it's kind of interesting. Head coach Frank Solich for Nebraska said, look for more up the gut. He said, they've done a good job, Texas, shutting down the option. He also said, look for a little bit more play action passing. Gave his defense an A. Mack Brown, on the other hand, said, good job by my defense. But as you saw in those stats at halftime, he wants more time for Applewhite. He challenged his offensive line to do so, said we've got to give him more time, and we've got to get more passing yards.
Now Jack and Dan Alexander back in at I-back. Seven carries for 35 yards. Gets the first call here to start the second half, and he picks up a couple of yards. So take a look at the quarterback comparison, and keep in mind what Gary Danielson told you, that the biggest surprise of this game is the fact that Eric Crouch has outpassed Major Applewhite.
There's no doubt about that, but Texas, as much as they want to throw the ball, still has to understand they have a bit of a mismatch at offensive tackle against those two rush defensive ends from Nebraska. They have to be careful. They don't want to just run the ball three times in the second half like they did against Kansas State.
Press defense shown by the Longhorns. Option looking there all over with Big Sean Rogers. The junior tackle out of La Porte, Texas, exploding again.
Very interesting on this football team, Brent. The number one tackler on the team is Casey Hampton, a defensive tackler. The defensive tackle. The number one player that gets tackles for a loss, Sean Rogers. Both of them are doing their job today.
The heart of any defense, isn't it? Those two defensive tackles.
Yeah,
Nose or
I'm not so sure Frank Solich trusts Jack Arute, because I don't think they're going to be able to run the ball up the middle.
Third down and 13. Going to try. Got a hole. They took a shot at it with Danny Alexander, but it's three and out. And Texas does what they have to do as DeAndre Lewis shuts it down.
I don't believe, if you look at what the Nebraska offense did the first three games to the second three, look how well the Texas defense is playing. Just one touchdown from Texas, and this crowd will turn and make it a huge advantage for the Longhorns.
Hayden Felt standing inside the Nebraska 5-yard line. Garcia back deep, hoping to give the Horns favorable field position. Beautiful punt into that wind. What a great punt into the wind, but penalty flag goes down. A penalty flag is thrown.
Remember when Texas was punting when they were backed up? They were getting maybe 15, 20 yards in turn on the exchange. Nebraska's going to get a huge, but you know what? It's going to be offsetting penalties. One by Nebraska on the punt and one by Texas on the return. They're going to do it again. I think Frank Solich has called a brilliant game so far in this game. Longtime play caller for Tom Osborne. It was a little tougher for him to be the head coach and call plays last year. He's more comfortable this year. Uh-oh.
Disregard the second flag. The second flag. He was blocked into the halo zone. The first flag was a personal hands to the face.
Well, Texas is surely going to force Nebraska to punt again against the wind. Remember where they had the ball, the 41-yard line. The officials are even confused.
Almost as long as a break for instant replay in the NFL.
We'll be penalized. Half the distance. Re-kick.
Officials did a poor job of sorting things out that time. It took way too long. I think it's a right tackle right over here that's going to get the hand to the face.
There you see.
Hand to the face mask on the rush. Remember, Texas had the ball on the 41. Let's see how big this penalty really is.
And Garcia moves into Nebraska territory. He's now standing at the Nebraska 44. Hayden Felt is in the Cornhuskers end zone, hoping to get another beauty out of there. Good field position. Garcia out of bounds at the 35-yard line. So the Horns with a golden opportunity after that 8-yard return. It'll be up to the Major. Timeout. Well, the penalty cost Nebraska 24 yards.
Yeah, there. Brent, when does 11 equal 24? Well, when the ball would have been back here and it ends up there, that's the difference of an 11-yard penalty because of half the difference in a 24-yard exchange.
Now the Major in Texas working with a 35-yard field, but they haven't done a thing against the black shirts. Oh. And nothing going there. A loss again. And rolling in is big play linebacker Julius Jackson from Gainesville, Texas. Standout player filling in for Eric Johnson. Did a fine job on that play. And now it's our Applebee's Game Fact. 1960. Only appearance in Austin. An unranked Nebraska came in here and upset Texas 14-13. Second down and 14. And the Nebraska defense doing its job again. They've shut everybody down. Cavill trying to find daylight, trying to get open. Major waits, comes back away from him to the running back. Hodges Mitchell dances free. Going for the end zone, forced out of bounds. 2 yards short of the end zone. A 36-yard play. And now maybe the toughest 2 yards of the afternoon for Texas.
Brent, a great read by Major. Watch the free safety jump Kwame Cabillo over the middle of the field. That's where Major was trying to throw the ball. Here comes the jump. He's going to come up. He reads that right there. He dumps it off to his back. That's playing quarterback. That's studying your film study, and that's why Major Applewhite plays good college football.
Chris Robertson, big back, checks into the backfield. He'll get the carry. Chris Robertson short of the goal line, and it'll be second down and goal. Remember what I told you, this might be the two toughest yards of the afternoon for this Longhorn offensive line.
You're exactly right. Chris Robinson now has carried the ball 12 times this year for Texas. He has 6 touchdowns. You know they give it to him close to the goal line.
Brown, the fullback.
This is the passing down, second down.
Robertson, end zone, touchdown, Texas. Stockton hoping to pull the Longhorns to within 3, and he does exactly that. So the matchup that a quarterback, especially a passing quarterback, thirsts for: get a running back and get him matched up with a linebacker. And in this case, the linebacker was Tony Ortiz. He had to take Hodges Mitchell, who slips out of the backfield, and then Robertson pounds across for the touchdown.
The play that made it, though, Brent. Major Applewhite looking at his keys. He wanted to go to Kwame Bill. You see his head turn? He was looking downfield, and then he dropped it off to his third guy. That's what made the touchdown. Good offense.
So Robertson, who has just scored the first rushing touchdown in 26 quarters against Nebraska's first team defense, pulls the horns to within 3, 11-17 left in the third. Walker's coming out again. And again, he's well short of the 20-yard line. He'd be better advised to take a knee in the end zone. That's twice now that they've done that.
That's not a bad batting average right there, Brent. Everybody wants to know, just give him the ball more. But he's a power guy. They use him near the goal line, and that's good return. Remember, Hodges Mitchell's a little small, so they use him in the tailback spot.
This is an important series for the Nebraska offense. Need a couple of first downs. Derek Crouch under center. The eye back. Fake is beautiful, and they pound right straight ahead that time. So Danny Alexander picks up 12 yards.
And this play earlier in the first half, Bobby Newcomb comes around, fakes the reverse, deep in the backfield back here, gets a lot of attention of the Texas defense, and all of a sudden Alexander's into the secondary.
First down up at the 24-yard line. The option, Crouch got the seam, turns it upfield, one of the fastest players, breaks free. Near midfield, down at the 49-yard line, DeAndre Lewis giving chase, but not before Eric rushes for 25 yards.
He's so explosive. And the first time, it looks like to me, in the spread sprint option, that the Nebraska offensive line handled the 2 defensive tackles for Texas. That's what allowed it.
You look down on Royal Memorial Stadium, 84,082, a Texas record crowd on hand. The Horns score their first touchdown minutes ago, and they close to within three of unbeaten Nebraska. On first down, Sean Rogers making another stop. Jackaroot.
Danielson, you were talking about the fact that that offensive line for Nebraska seemed to be handling a little better the tackles for Texas. Well, that's exactly what Frank Solich went over and challenged his linemen to do while they were watching their defense out on the field. He said, you've got to get your technique better. He said, you've also got to explode a little better. He said, if you don't, we can't run our offense.
It's amazing what those two big pluggers can do inside.
Second down and seven. Timeout. It is called with 9:36 to go in the third. Nebraska 13, Texas 10. Nebraska unbeaten and chasing Penn State and Florida State in the rankings. Penn State and a Donnybrook today with Purdue. Florida State goes tonight at Clemson. Here it is. Crouch stands tall. Got a man on a one and overthrow him. Incomplete. Let's send you to John Saunders. John, Nittany Lions of Purdue. What's going on, my friend?
Brent, like Nebraska, they're trying to stay unbeaten. Kevin Thompson back in at quarterback. Remember, he got knocked out last week. Hooking up with Chaffee Fields, 78 yards as the D-back loses him. Gives Penn State the lead for the first time, 21-14. For more, log on to ESPN.com, part of the GO Network. Brent.
John, that's not enough points.
I think you're right.
What a scoop I just delivered. Man, am I smart. Third down and seven. Crouch pulls out. Diving incomplete.
One of the most difficult passes to throw against the wind is when you throw sideways. It blows the ball more. You'd be better off throwing the ball directly into the wind. It won't have as much effect. It's like our slices in golf. They slice a little bit more. The wind makes this one slice. You hook or slice?
Oh, I slice. Don't I wish I could hook like you, my friend. Fourth down, forced to punt here again. And of course, the last time, Texas winding up because of a penalty with outstanding field position, and they moved to their first touchdown. Now from midfield, Haydenfeld with an excellent leg. Got a little bit too much on it. Headed for the end zone, and it'll come out on the 20-yard line. They were hoping to bury him inside the 20-yard line, but it was not to be. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Jeep Grand Cherokee with legendary off-road capability. Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter, we measure success one investor at a time. Inspire technology with a human touch, Nokia connecting people, and Burger King, when you have it your way, it just tastes better. Gary, I want to go back on something because I think we made it sound in the first half like Miami had lost.
That
not over, they pull it out. So obviously, as Terry Bowden said at halftime, that will help Virginia Tech's strength of schedule down the stretch. But even at that, I'm not sure that their strength of schedule is going to help them if these fellas like Nebraska stay unbeaten, but we shall see.
Just another team to watch besides Penn State. Now you got to watch Virginia Tech if you're one of these top teams.
First down and 10. And Hodges Mitchell dances outside, turns it up. Hodges Mitchell running with authority here in the second half. Kwame Cavill, here he is throwing at four times. He's caught three, but only 1 yard after the catch. And one of the reasons why, well, there's a great defensive back out there, Ralph Brown, number 22. He's one of the leaders. He's off toward the top of your screen. Now, Cavill's going on into the slot formation, and the faster wideout is actually his man in this particular defensive set. So Cavill coming back to the line, catches it on the screen, and down it goes. And by getting Cavill away from Brown, they got him at least a little daylight. And I asked Ralph Brown if he was looking forward to the matchup with Kwame Cavill.
Yeah, I look forward to that matchup. I look forward to playing teams that throw the ball a lot because I can display my talents, and my job out there won't be boring because of teams that run. I really don't get in too much action. I'm a cornerback here. We play man-to-man, so I'm looking forward to this game.
And he'll get his chance here as the afternoon unfolds, and then again next year on Sunday.
Brent, one more reason that Kwame Cavill's having trouble get the ball. Clint Finley, the free safety, has shaded his way to help.
First down and 10. Mitchell dances back to the middle and pounds away. Jackaroo.
Well, Brent, you know, you can't blame Hodges Mitchell if he tried to gain about 12 pounds last year because all he looked at is the guy in front of him, Ricky Williams, who was a hoss. But so one of the things that he did is he used to go to Chili's and he ordered the dessert called the Banana Rumba. Well, he was slow because he used to eat those desserts. In the offseason, he dropped those pounds. He's a lighter, leaner Hodges Mitchell. And you know what's happened at Chili's? They had to get rid of the dessert. Nobody buys it anymore.
You know, Mitchell is averaging better than 4 yards a pop. 12 for 53 on second down now. Drop free, fumble, loose football. Scramble.
Looks like Texas got the ball back.
Nebraska, Johnson doesn't agree with you, but the official, I think, is indicating that the Longhorns indeed have recovered it, and Applewhite may have saved it himself.
Major Applewhite, very clean blitz this time, a mistake. Saw that Carlos Polk coming right up the gut. Major Applewhite's very fortunate to wrestle that thing away from Carlos Polk.
Matt Anderson, the sophomore center, down in the middle of that offensive line, has his hands full with Carlos Polk, who has been stepping up into the gap all day long. Now he goes over to the right side of the formation and gets ready. Third down. They rush five. Middle, complete but short of the first down, and Texas must punt it.
See, there's Clint Finley right there, the free safety. They are giving Major Applewhite a look as if he's open, but they're really bracketing him the whole game, and that's why it's tough to get the ball to Kwame Cavill. Coming from this side, here's the free safety. Cavill will come right here, but watch Finley's eyes. He knows where Kwame Cavill is. He jumps it, kick the ball.
And as a result, forced a punt. Keeping down his yards after a catch. Joe Walker is back deep. Bad snap. They've got a piece of this one.
Tremendous punt.
How did he get it off? And it rolls down at the 26-yard line. Ryan Long, what a wonderful job. 37 yards as he somehow, wait to see how he's greeted on the sideline. There'll be coaches walking down toward him and everybody else. Took ball, a pop and got it off.
Yes, he did. The ball rolled back that time. Dropped it once and then got it, and it was like a soccer play getting hit at the same time. Holy cow. Might be the hardest hit of the game.
Mike Brown was all over him, the Rover man. Now it is first down for the Cornhuskers. They lead it three. Pound middle. Break the eye back free, and he's ridden down at the 47-yard line. Danny Alexander's best run of the day. 27 yards for Alexander, and he has now rushed for better than 70 yards here today.
Remember what Carl Reese told us. They're going to have to live with some plays other than the quarterback. All eyes are on Crouch. Hands the ball off. You got a lot of guys looking at the quarterback, and all of a sudden, there's the tailback has the ball.
12 carries, 82 yards. So Alexander, the leading rusher. Nebraska playing with half a field now. Here's the toss. Alexander picks his way to daylight and slashes close to the 40-yard line with Lee Jackson making the stop. And a reminder that tonight on the ABC Big Picture Show, Michelle Pfeiffer and Robert Redford star in Up Close and Personal tonight at 8, 7 Central.
Well, there's been a lot of up close and personal hits in this football game. You know, Brent, Texas's defense have not given up an individual 100-yard rusher yet this season. Could happen. Alexander's closing in on an 88 yards.
Second down and 5. Option look, Crouch. Fake penalty flag is thrown on the play. Well, the great views that we're seeing here are being brought to you this afternoon by the Monster.com blimp. Monster.com is a leading global careers website with over 4 million members worldwide. Are you a member yet?
Jackaroot said Frank Solich challenges offensive linemen to hold up in the middle. So what do? They only heard hold, because that's what happened. They held up in the middle, and they're going to get a penalty on it.
It's only the third penalty today against Nebraska.
And the one on the punting game was huge for them.
So they bring it back to the Nebraska 49-yard line. The second down and 14, and we haven't heard from Bobby Newcomb here lately. He'll go off to the slot on the left side of this passing formation by Crouch and the Cornhusker. Crouch in trouble, down at the 41-yard line. Ahmad Brooks stormed in from the cornerback spot. And let us check in with John Saunders. John.
Brent, it's time for the Burger King play of the day. LeVar Arrington got his touchdown on a sack, and now Courtney Brown will get one on an interception. Tips it to himself, takes it to 27 yards with Drew Brees in hot pursuit, but not quickly enough. Penn State, as we mentioned, trying to keep that goose egg in the loss column with a two-touchdown lead. Meanwhile, Stanford, trying to fight back against USC, has grabbed the lead 28-24. Brent.
John, that Courtney fellow will be playing on ABC in the Pro Bowl in about 5 years.
You're right.
What a great player he is. There's going to be a timeout called by Crouch. He came to the line, checked the defense, and called the timeout.
You know, that last sack against Eric Crouch was really a designed running play, sniffed out by Texas. Here's the play coming from it. You'll see coming from the end. Woodard, this is a run all the way. A blitz from the corner that time. And this thing is snuffed up. Ahmad Brooks is right there to make the play. You know, you really have to admire those inside guys for Texas. They're big, yet they keep playing. That's, you know, carrying a lot of weight.
Well, a reminder about college football coming your way on ABC next Saturday afternoon. We move toward the heart of the season. The November stretch is with us. You're in the Big 12, Oklahoma, Colorado, or Oklahoma State, Texas. And then some of our other regional coverage. So games will be selected depending upon the results, so you can check the time and listings in your local area. Third down and 21. Newcomb. Split out to the left side. Remember, they need 21 yards on this third down. Newcomb. And a fake play works as they bust the eye back short of the first down. So Texas bought the fake, and then Dan Alexander pounded for about 19 yards, leaving them 2 yards shy.
Texas is playing pass. They're playing option. They're playing. You see, look at Aaron Humphrey over there. He's playing the quarterback, and someone else has the football.
When he saw Newcomb come around behind him, he went and took that fake. And now, for the first time, Dan Alexander, the first running back with 100 yards here against Texas. 14 carries, 106 yards. Here's fourth and two. Here's Crouch on the option. Late pitch, out of bounds, Texas football. And Aaron Humphrey, who gave way on the fake, comes up big on fourth down.
Two fourth down plays. Texas's defense has held and kept Texas in the football game. Aaron Humphrey right here is going to just go wide. Keeps going wide, nowhere to go. Look at Hampton right here, the defensive tackle. No place to go up. Short pitch, no room to pitch the ball. Crouch has to pitch it. It's fourth down, and there it is, another stop for that Texas defense. Both penalties, two out of three penalties for Nebraska has really hurt them.
Texas wind at their back for 2.5 minutes. Play fake, Applewhite. Got him on a slant. Camille slips to the 40-yard line, first down on a 17-yard gain. Remember that Breeze is at Major Applewhite's back right now with 2:33. I think I said there was about a minute and a half. Actually, it's 2:30 to go now for Mack Brown's horns here with the wind at their back.
Mack Brown has to be thrilled to be in this football game, and now the crowd is back in the game.
Craver has Cavill off to the right. Applewhite back again. Got him, Cavill! Out of bounds at the 12-yard line. He turned in behind the corner and before the safety could get there, and it results in a 27-yard gain. The horns within striking distance again.
Very subtle change by Greg Davis, the coordinator for Texas. Remember, Kwame Cavill was in the slot. Now they've moved them out wide, away from those safeties, and make it a little easier for Major Applewhite to get the ball to him. Good coaching.
Texas may have to throw from here, however. They've still got 14 tough yards to go. And the Major will do it on first down. Got a slant. Touchdown, Texas! Kwame Cavill. Chris Stockton. Texas regains the lead. They go up by four, 17-13. 2 minutes left in the third.
Kwame Cavill, move him out a little wider, get him away from the safeties, continue to throw the ball at him. He's one of those players in big games who just direct the ball at him.
The key is Greg Davis. I think you put your finger on it, how he changed the patterns here.
Moved them out a little wider, a little more one-on-one coverage, and no matter how good you are, when you got a big play receiver like that, it's tough to cover him. You know who he reminds me of? Reminds me of Chris Carter, a big receiver, a physical receiver, now with the Minnesota Vikings, years with Ohio State. He's always going to catch the ball in traffic.
You saw how he initiated contact on Ralph Brown. Cavill, nicknamed Cadillac. Never met a pass he couldn't catch, baby.
Major Applewhite, 6 for 6 in that drive. Excuse me, in this quarter, 6 for 6 this quarter. Got off to a slow start, 9 for 21. Just like a week ago, now he's come back, he's finding his rhythm.
So a year ago, Major Applewhite went into Lincoln and into that 47 game home winning streak with a forward pass. And now Joe Walker for the Cornhuskers has an alley and pounds out to the 25-yard line. Texas fans in particular will never forget the winning touchdown pass. Wayne McGarrity, I believe, was on the receiving end of that one in Lincoln, and the Major was doing the chucking. Let's take a look and watch what happens as the Major, under pressure, fires.
Oh,
never saw the catch. Got back up. Said, did he get it? He's got it. And they win it, 2016. Now he's got him ahead again. 17-13, but a long way to go. Alexander to the 30-yard line, and Everett Rawls makes the stop.
You know what was so impressive, Brent, about that throw to beat Nebraska last year? You know, as a quarterback, when you sidearm one of those throws in there, if it doesn't work, everybody's going to come back to you and say, why did you throw one like that? It takes a lot of guts to throw it, let alone complete it.
Tommy Beveridge brings the play in from the Nebraska sideline. Second down and 5. Play fake. Throw back now to the fullback. Miller rumbles to the 45, 44-yard line.
Crosses pass complete.
14 yards. And a reminder that tomorrow, join us as we preview the Tour Championship. We'll look at the Players Champions Golf Club and preview the candidates for the year-end awards. PGA Tour Championship preview show tomorrow at 3:30 Eastern Time. Pretty good golfer over here in his luxury box. Pretty excited about what's happening here. Ben Crenshaw, graduate of Texas, one of the great golfers to come out of the terrific golf program here. They're faking the end around again, and Alexander just battering his way into Texas territory. A hard running eye back. He now has carried 16 times for 120 yards.
Dan Alexander had 60 yards against this Texas defense last year when he came in as a substitute. There it is in two halves, 120. I guess you get 60 in one half, you get 120 in two halves, but they're going to have to continue to use their tailback because Texas is trying to stop the quarterback.
Final seconds here in the third quarter. Alexander trips up for the first down. And the clock stops on that first down, so the Cornhuskers with a chance here for one more snap before we bring the third quarter to a close. And time runs out before they get another snap off. Texas kicked an early field goal to lead it 3-0. Then it was all Nebraska, 13 unanswered. But here in the second half, Major Applewhite leads the Horns to two touchdowns. That pass to Cavill, and Texas leads it 17-13 with a quarter still to go. Back after these messages and words from our ABC stations. A quarter to go. And Texas with two consecutive wins over Nebraska. A Big 12 championship up at the TWA Dome in St. Louis. And a year ago in Lincoln. And now a determined Nebraska team with Alexander stuffed in the hole. Sean Rogers has been a man in that defensive line all day for Texas. Jack and Root.
Well, right at the quarter break, Mac Brown came over and told me the third quarter was played exactly the way he had hoped. I asked him about the wind situation. He said, Jack, we actually wanted the wind in the third quarter. We'll give Nebraska the wind favor in the fourth. He also mentioned, hey, as you said, Gary, we've got our crowd back in it. And that indeed, with no pun intended, is the 12th man.
And they rise now to make a lot of noise. On second down, crouch play fake. Coming deep down the middle, Wistrom got it inside the 10-yard line. Tracy Wistrom comes up with another huge play. The sophomore from Webb City, Missouri. But hold on, there is a flag back by the line of scrimmage.
I think it's going to be holding against Texas, and they're going to decline it. It's going to be holding right over here on the Atlanta line of scrimmage, but here's the other guy, Winstrom, going down the middle. Bootleg play, the holding is outside the picture. There's Winstrom going deep, and Eric Crouch throws a perfect ball deep over the outstretched arm of Greg Brown, and that's a pass offense off the option as good as there is in college football.
Nobody's prouder of Tracy, I'm sure, than Grant, who was up in St. Louis watching, getting ready for the Cleveland Browns, the amazing story in the NFL, and nobody this week has asked me if the game has passed Dick Vermeil by. I don't understand that. He's suddenly the reigning genius.
Big Dick will let him watch.
All right. First down and goal. Throw back. They want Crouch. Buckhalter has to keep it, and he is still battling his way to the 9-yard line.
He fumbled the ball. I think Dominic Raioli picked that ball up. Wow. Great defense by Texas stuffing out this play. You were exactly right, Brent. They wanted to throw it back to the quarterback. Crouch will pitch it, and then he goes out for a pass. Buckhalter, probably the best thrower, goes one way, nobody open, comes back. Here's the fumble, boom, it goes out. Raioli gets the ball and saves a big drive.
Second down for the Huskers. Buckhalter stays in the game. And a timeout is being called. That will leave Nebraska with one. We'll take a break. So Texas leading, but let me correct a mistake. Nebraska had used two timeouts. I forgot there was two they'd used in the third. And so now they are without a timeout as we go down the stretch. Thomas steps in motion behind Crouch. Looks for Newcomb, slammed at the 6-yard line by Greg Brown, the free safety.
Greg Brown has done such a nice job substituting for Quentin Jammer. That's who they lost, the free safety earlier in the year. Greg Brown has come in, he's been solid. Here comes the blitz from the corner again. It's Ahmad Brooks. Crouch throws it perfectly, but just slightly behind Newcomb, and there's Brown. Huge play right here.
It is third and goal. 12:37 left in the game. Here's Buckhalter, slams toward the end zone and didn't get there. Doesn't get there. Fumble is called. So a tremendous turn of events forced by the Texas defense inside the 5-yard line.
The pitch play that scored before for Nebraska. Watch Buckhalter try to stretch the ball out. He makes a mistake, he stretches it out, and the ball comes loose. It's a great call. Hampton makes the recovery. One more look, you can see he was not down before that ball popped out. It was kicked, and then Hampton makes the save.
Now the black shirts get down for a very important defensive stand here for the Huskers, unbeaten and trailing. Hodges Mitchell slaps into a hole. Hodges spins out. A huge run. The largest crowd ever in Texas history watching a Big 12 dandy here this afternoon. Texas has won the last two games that they have played in this series, and with 11:52 to go, the Horns lead Nebraska 17-13, second down and three.
This is one of the better field position games I've seen. Both coaches using the win, using their defenses to stay in this game.
Mitchell, slant, first down, Texas. Hodges Mitchell, 14 carries for 69 yards now against this Nebraska defense.
Let's give a salute to that Texas offensive line. They lost all the starters except Raisler. This time they do a good job. Good blocking at the end of the line by Mike Jones, the tight end. There's Mitchell right in the line of scrimmage, and that's a huge first down for this offense. They don't want to punt down here inside the 10-yard line.
Repositions Brown. Toss play to Hodges Mitchell. Behind Brown. Picks up a yard and no more. You know, the one question that Eric Crouch has not yet answered. Can he in the fourth quarter, if McBride's defense gets it over to the offense, can Crouch finish off and win a game in the fourth quarter? You go back to last year in Nebraska, he had a chance. Gave up a little short. Then that non-penalty called against Kansas State. That in Manhattan. And Nebraska failed there. He's going to have to try to do it here again. Second down and nine. First things first. And Applewhite now uses his first timeout with the clock ticking down. Did not want to take the penalty. And Applewhite comes over to the sideline. From behind the bench. And You can just imagine the coaches would love to get the ball back in number 12's hands, Newcomb, before this one's over. 10-23, second down and 9. Meanwhile, Mac Brown of the Longhorns looking to keep this going. Here comes the blitz, and they run right into the spot. It'll be third down as Mike Brown, the Rover, up to make another tackle. A year ago against them in Lincoln, I think he made 19 tackles in that game. One
Mike Brown, almost a fourth linebacker in this front that Charlie McBride uses. He's a strong safety. Rover has to be multi-dimensional. You know, these linebackers run so well, but Mike Brown is a defensive back that has to hit like a linebacker.
Here's the third down. And today, Brown from that spot with 9 tackles for McBride. Shotgun, blind side, gets it off, incomplete. Cavill, the intended receiver, and it was a little bit too far out in front of the receiver that time.
So the dreaded punt against the wind.
So Purdue comes back with a touchdown. It's 28-25 in the third quarter of that game.
That You're was so right. 28 points ain't going to be enough.
That's the first incompletion of this half for Major Applewhite. And so Nebraska looking to get field position. Walker and Newcomb back deep. Low punt going to take a bounce. Fielded by Walker at the 46-yard line. Down at the 45-yard line. We'll take a break. 9:27 to go. An 8-yard return. Crouch will have less than half a field to work with. Timeout. Nebraska ball. First down at the Texas 45. Alexander, the eye back behind Crouch. The option. Crouch keeps it. Cuts. 12 yards. To the 33-yard line, and we check in with John Saunders on that Purdue-Penn State game. John.
Brent, as you well know, Drew Brees, when you have a quarterback, you said 28 wouldn't be enough. 5 yards here to Randall Lane, and not done. Say, hey, let's go for the 2-point conversion. This time, again, it's Brees' little shovel pass underneath to Randall Lane. Takes it in for the 2-point conversion, and just like that, Purdue within 3. Brent.
That'll take about 2 more hours to play that game. First down. Crouch with an inside shovel pass. Here comes Alexander rumbling to the 10-yard line. So we saw one in West Lafayette for the 2-point conversion. And Nebraska says, not a bad play. Let us use that.
Brent, how do they have time to practice all these plays? Nebraska's got more offense than anybody in the country. And everybody thinks Nebraska's simple. They're not simple. They got everything. Here's the shovel pass coming across this way, inside. Great call again. You're going to try to take the quarterback away. We're going to give it to somebody else.
22-yard gain. Hampton is replaced. He's out of the game right now, and Cole Pittman checks in. So it is first down at the 13-yard line. Option. Here's the pitch. Here's Alexander. And he is slammed at the 10-yard line. Now, remember the last time down here, it was Correll Buckhalter who had scored in the first half, extending toward the end zone. He turns it over. So they come back with the option this time, and they protect the football.
Brent, this is the 6th time Nebraska's been inside the 20. They've got 2 fumbles, 2 field goals, and a touchdown. Not very good today inside the 20.
Hampton's back. Here's second down. To the wide side. Crouch is going to keep it. End zone, touchdown. Nebraska leads it.
Spread them out, run the option. Frank Solich is calling a great football game against a very good defense here at Texas.
Now for the 3-point lead. And remember, Applewhite and the Longhorns must move into that breeze when they get the ball back. It sits on a field goal right now. So Eric Crouch, who several games into the season, took over as the starting quarterback because of these decisive moves he makes running the option. Nebraska leads it. Timeout. Seven minutes and 52 seconds remaining. And Eric Crouch with that decisive move off the option puts the Cornhuskers ahead. And now Haydenfeld. Flowers and Jones back deep. Jones is going to come out. Little return, Jones to the 25-yard line. In his own words, Eric Crouch will tell you how he scored the touchdown.
Well, I just got the snap. Found my guy that I'm supposed to option off of. I tried to attack him. The guy ended up taking the eye back. I made a decisive decision right away, not even thinking about it. I cut up field and tried to get as much as I could.
9 yards was enough for the touchdown, and now Nebraska leads it.
Pretty prophetic from him right there. Personal foul, face mask right there. You see it. And now, Brent, you know, all those option plays, Eric Crouch finally got loose on that drive. Two big runs in that drive by Eric Crouch. They didn't stop him. That was the goal.
So the penalty moves the ball out to the 40-yard line.
You know, you said the Penn State game's not over. This game's not over either. Applewhite now smiling. He gets a chance to win it.
Play fake from the hip. Applewhite going down the middle. Nunes got it on the juggle. First down at the 21-yard line. Nunes and a beautiful play fake by Major Applewhite for a gain of 39 yards.
Ryan Nunes has caught 28 passes in the last five games. Watch Kwame Cabille affect the free safety. He's going to jump Kwame Cabille. That allows the ball to go over the top to Nunes. Beats Ralph Brown on the play. They're playing a lot of defense to stop Kwame. Other people are open.
Hodges Mitchell, the running back. Matt Anderson picks up the safety. Here comes Hodges for a couple of yards. Tackle made by Kyle Vandenbosch, the junior from Larchwood, Iowa.
You know, we haven't called those defensive ends much in this defense for Nebraska today. Vandenbosch, Aaron Wills, Chris Kelsey have not been making a lot of plays.
An ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Chevrolet Trucks, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Dell Computer, pioneering direct internet ideas for your business. Be direct, Dell. Applebee's, you belong at Applebee's. And Priority Mail from the U.S. Postal Service. Largest crowd ever, and they have watched a good one here. Kirk Hughes shaken up and coming off the field. Look, Derek Dockery checks in, Gary.
Look at the punishment Eric Crouch has to take to get his 200-plus yards.
Second down and 7 for the Horns. Cabille, the motion receiver. Here's Hodges Mitchell, short side. Battered at the 18-yard line by Steve Warren, the nose man from Springfield, Missouri. As a reminder, we'll have the Chevrolet players of this game from both teams, and Chevrolet makes a $1,000 contribution to each University General Scholarship fund. Beginning this year, Chevrolet also donates two $1,000 high school scholarships. Third down coming up, and it's a biggie. A field goal would leave them tied with 6:16 to go.
Remember, that field goal is dead into the wind. If you hook or slice it, it's going to be magnified. Kwame Cabille in the slot. Two guys are going to take it.
They show blitz. trying to get there. Major's got it off underneath, and he uses his tight end, Mike Jones. Jones, still going. Jones, touchdown, Texas. Oh, what a run by Mike Jones of 17 yards after the catch. The young man from Marshall High School in San Antonio. Four again for the Longhorns.
Another brilliant read by Major Applewhite. When you have a go-to player, defenses start to tilt towards them. Two players take Kwame Cavell. Major reads it again. Watch this. Left side of your screen. Two guys are going to take Kwame Cavell. Ball goes back. Major throws it out. These two guys had Kwame. The ball goes out here for a touchdown.
Applewhite this half is 8 of 9 for 166 yards and two touchdowns.
Right there. Two on one. That means somebody's open right here. Perfect read by your quarterback. That's how you're taught to do it. And that's why one player can help another player score a touchdown.
What a half by the Major.
And remember, we talked in the first half that Major said, I'm going to be determined to be patient. I'm not going to worry about a bad start. 9 for 21. Second half, focus in, throw the ball. I'm going to be patient, win ugly. This is pretty. This isn't ugly.
Walker and Craver back deep for Nebraska. Standing on the 5-yard line. And it goes to the short man. So Tracy Wistrom fields the kickoff and comes out to the 35-yard line, and we check in with Jack Aru. Jack.
Well, Brent, you were wondering about Eric Crouch's abilities to play what we might call the two-minute drill. There's no timeouts left in this game. Granted, there's 5 minutes and some odd seconds left, but it's one thing that Eric Crouch has thought about, considering the fact that he's had his three losses, not being able to convert at the last minute. He says, I'm much better at it. He said, in fact, 24 seconds this year seems to me sometimes like 24 minutes.
A major rule difference between the college game and the pros. Remember, the clock stops on a first down. Lots of time, 5:42. Option look, Crouch goes nowhere. Loses a yard. It'll be second down and 11 as he has jumped at the line of scrimmage. DeAndre Lewis and Anthony Hicks. Hicks, a linebacker who played so well last year in Lincoln.
Well, Aaron Humphrey was also in on that play, and this time he, as a defensive end, said, my man's a quarterback, I'm going to take the quarterback. Aaron Humphrey hurt, nicked with a rib, back in there playing this game.
Second down and 11. Straight back, Crouch under pressure. Wanted to set the screen to Alexander, but he was forced to throw an incompleted pass that time. Aaron Humphrey and DeAndre Lewis coming.
Five minutes to go in the game right now. The goal that Texas had, and Carl Reese, the defensive coordinator, says, we have to force Texas to throw when we want them to throw. They put him into one of those situations right now. Third and long, 5 minutes to go.
It doesn't get any bigger for Frank Solich than this play right here. Fake by Crouch, in trouble again. Throws back across the field. Davidson dives and got it. Penalty flag on the play. The magic man does it again. Who will ever forget the catch in Missouri? And now, from out of nowhere, he may have made a game-saving catch again on third and 11.
Well, You're right. It wasn't as good as the miracle catch against Missouri, but this was darn near a miracle throw and catch that saved the ball game. There's no doubt. Interference on the play against Irvis Hill in coverage.
Result of the play was an incomplete pass. But we have defensive pass interference.
Wow, incomplete. That means it's a 15-yard penalty instead of the spot foul. Backside, no way he thinks he's going to get the ball. Eric Crouch just lets it fly. Wanted to throw it outside. There's the interference. Ball was in the air. Let's see if he catches it. Held him again. There's another interference. Boy, he caught that ball.
What's incomplete about that ball?
That's clear.
Oh, the coaches are on the field.
Absolutely.
Oh, that's a catch. This is highway robbery.
He caught that ball, clearly caught that ball.
From previous spot, automatic down.
There's the interference.
And
here's
despite
the catch.
The interference,
here's the
watch
catch.
The catch.
He's got it, there's no doubt.
Oh, that's a brutal, brutal ball. Especially in this situation.
Brent, it didn't kill him though. It only cost him 10 yards. Nebraska has to refocus now and concentrate on the last 5 minutes of the game.
And they come right back out, Gary.
Absolutely.
The coaches went back to the side. First down. Pound to the middle with Alexander and get much of it back that time on that rushing attack with 4:49 to go.
Nebraska has confidence they can move the ball. They cannot concentrate on the bad call right now. Concentrate on making first downs. They're really in four down territory. A field goal won't do them. There you see, down the stretch. Crouch has been magnificent the whole game. Third down conversions have been a little bit of a problem, and no timeouts. A big story.
The Texas defense will try to force a turnover. Second down and three. Crouch inside pitch, dangerous. Alexander close to the first down. DeAndre Lewis bringing him down here with 4:13 to go. But the war continues in Austin, Texas before a record crowd, and they are still here watching a fine college football game between Nebraska and Texas at Royal Memorial Stadium. The Longhorns have hooked the Cornhuskers the last two times they have played, one in the Big 12 championship game and then last year up in Lincoln. They have spoiled so many things for the Cornhuskers. In that Big 12 championship game, they denied Nebraska a chance to shoot for a third consecutive national championship. A year ago, they ended the long home winning streak. Now with Frank Solich looking for his first win against Nebraska, back on the other side with a first down.
You know the powers to be in the Big 12 Conference love this game. This could be a marquee matchup for the Big 12 Conference. Texas and Nebraska, and all three games have been great football games.
And the whistle before the snap.
Movement up front.
Costly 5 yards. It'll come back to the 45-yard line, and who knows, maybe there will be a fourth game in this series.
That's
maybe
right.
Nebraska will win the North, Texas the South, and they'll get together again in San Antonio. So, time permitting, we'll check in with John and Terry on the Thrifty Car Rental post-game report. We still have about, well, inside of 4 minutes now to go. Remember, Nebraska is without a timeout. First down at 15. Gibson and Thomas. Two wideouts off to Crouch's right. He's going to run the option in that direction. Here comes the pitch now to Alexander, who slips to the 40-yard line. Just beyond the original line of scrimmage.
Texas lost focus on Eric Crouch and the option twice in the last drive. It cost them a touchdown. It looks like they've backed, zeroed in on who they have to stop. Now, Nebraska will counter. They will do the things with other players. They'll throw the ball. Remember, second and 10, it's really like first and 10 during normal part of the game. It's four down territory.
Three wideouts. Second down and 10. Option. Crouch. keeps it, picks up perhaps 3 yards on second down with Greg Brown making the tackle. Pressure by Hicks. Number 55, the senior from Dallas Lake Highlands, rolling in and breathing fire.
Anthony Hicks had the monster game. There he is right there coming from the backside on this play. Last year he had 13 tackles, 2 sacks, and he caused a fumble. He might have saved the game right there.
Nebraska faces a fourth down. It's unbeaten season on the line. 0 for 2 today on fourth down. They need 7 yards. Shotgun. Crouch. Back against the grain. Texas football. Texas football. Hicks again. As you look down on the scene here at Royal Memorial Stadium, Texas leading Nebraska 24-20, and they have just held on fourth down here, Gary Danielson.
Anthony Hicks again is going to come right up there and make the play. The linebacker, Crouch, has no time to get this ball away. He tries to throw another miracle. This time, everyone is on the player, the throwback screen. And now, with 2:15 to go, Texas needs one first down to finish this game.
First down and 10. Nebraska needs the football back. Hodges Mitchell dances into the middle of the black shirt, swarming defense for a yard. Vandenbosch to stop again.
We talked about all the hits that Eric Crouch was going to take today. The last two have become from this guy, number 55, Anthony Hicks. He had the great game a year ago. He's been struggling all year with a knee problem. Comes back, and the senior gets involved late in the game.
Without any timeouts, it is just devastating to Nebraska.
Yep.
Now that they've spent those timeouts with the clock just running down on them, and the Longhorns using extra seconds. And here's Hodges Mitchell dancing wide, staying in bounds. Down at the 45-yard line.
Here's the two scores that decided it.
One, Crouch
put Nebraska into it first. And then the big tight end for Texas comes back. Might be the winning touchdown of the game.
Third down and 3. Looking for a first down. Inside of a minute. Nebraska can't stop it. Back in Mitchell's hands, bashed in the hole, and here it is, fourth down, with the second still ticking away, but at least they have forced a punt.
The 25-second clock has not started yet.
And remember this, this was the third punt blocked on this night, and as a result, North Carolina State would beat Texas. It is fourth down and 1. And the Texas coaching staff will bring the offense all the way over to the sideline because the seconds are ticking away on the clock. There, the play clock expires with 4 seconds to go. There's the penalty for too much time.
Well, why did Texas do that? They could have taken a timeout with 1 second to go. They have 2 and kept it 4th and inches.
I think probably they were planning on punting anyway, right?
Well, I don't think they want to punt, Brent. I think they're just going to run out to the side of the field and try to kill the clock.
Well, they lead it by 4 points. The major can run all the way back to the locker room.
Yes, he can.
Give two and get out of here.
Just don't fall down, right?
Would you believe it? Texas defeats Nebraska for a third straight time. Amazing. One of the Magnificent Seven falls. Nebraska is unbeaten no more. Six and one, and Penn State slugging it out, remember. Florida State tonight on ESPN goes against Clemson. And our Chevrolet MVPs, Dan Alexander of Nebraska, rushed for 130 yards, and the major, what a day he had, winding up 17 to 30, 213 yards, two touchdowns. Now we go to Jackaroo, Jack.
I gotta go. Mac, how big is this win for you?
Well, it's a great win for us to beat the number three team in the country, Nebraska, at our place and come from behind 13 to 3. Credit their kids for the hard fight, but credit our kids for coming from behind and winning.
You may have to meet them again in the Big 12 championship.
Well, that'd be great. They're a great team, and it'd be another great challenge for us to play them.
The eyes of Texas is playing. Enjoy it with your team.
Mac Brown, who has put the show back on the road here in Austin. Last year he was carried off the field in Lincoln. Today he gets a ride in Austin, Texas, before a record crowd. And for Texas Longhorn fans, it just doesn't get any better than this. 24-20. Texas wins it. For Jack Arute, Gary Danielson, I'm Brett Musburger. Stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com. Part of the Go Network. So long, everybody.